is that the government wants to send some signals to international markets to calm the jitteriness we've had there over the last week or so, and to essentially show the markets that the government is not spending in a careless, carefree way, that they do still have an eye on the money, an eye on the borrowing levels. And one way of doing that, they say, is by, as Sir Robert Buckland said in that interview, taking a rigorous approach to bear down on public expenditure. Now, we've had very similar tone coming from Kwasi Kwarteng, the Chancellor, writing in the newspapers, The Telegraph this morning, saying that he'll set out a plan to get debt falling at the end of November in his statement there, and that they would have sustainable and sensible spending and borrowing. Now, what might that look like? Well, Simon Clark, another key ally of Liz Truss, the Levelling Up Secretary, has done an interview in The Times today where he's talked about the mismatches he sees it between having an economy that is not productive enough and having a large welfare bill, and how those two are not compatible. He also talked about capital spending projects, building stuff, things that were announced under the Boris Johnson government, and how that may need to be prioritised or some of them delayed. And I think you put all that together, and as you can see from the Times headline there, many people take this as potentially a return to the austerity years of David Cameron. Economists we were talking to yesterday said that the combination of the level of rising prices and inflation and all of the tax cuts would mean that there could potentially need to be spending restraint in the order of what we got in those first Cameron years. Now, that, I think, will alarm many Conservative MPs, because it's certainly not what the government stood on in 2019 in the election. It is alarming as well the leaders and finance ministers of the devolved governments in Wales, Scotland and Northern Ireland, who of course get an appropriate amount of money from the UK government centrally, and are potentially seeing that those amounts coming down. They have written to Kwasi Kwarteng today, in which they've been expressing their alarm about the situation. They've said that the UK government has chosen to make things significantly worse by announcing a huge package of tax cuts for the most wealthy, without any credible explanation of how these will be paid for. Urgent action is required now to address the issues facing our economy, public services and households across the country. Such action cannot wait until the update you have announced will take place in November. So clearly, devolved leaders not reassured. I think as Conservative MPs make their way to Birmingham this weekend for the annual get-together, the annual conference, many are looking for reassurance as well. Today, Mark Fulbrook, who is the Chief of Staff for Liz Truss, has sent a message out to all MPs saying he will be regularly sending them graphics to their mobile phone number to help explain the plan, saying that it's clear that where people understand it, they are prepared to give it a chance. So a lot of reassuring and reassurance going on, both to international markets, but also to the party's own MPs.